Alrighty guys, welcome back to your 40 second video, and in between the last video and this video, look at all of the work I have done. I created all of these functions to calculate all the statistics that we need. Now, you guys are probably like, OMG, WTF, BBQ, why? I don't know, you might like barbecue, but I'm not going to go ahead and talk you guys through all of these functions because, like I said in the last video, it's pretty obvious what they all do, and if you don't know what they do, there's a little comment above. Now, in order for you guys to get this file, just go ahead and download it from my forum, and you guys will be good to go. So, now that we calculated all of the necessary statistics for the user's account links on the left-hand side, of course, now what we have to do is build these links right here. Now, like I said, what I'm going to do is I'm going to build them one time and then use them whenever we need them instead of coding them on every single page. So what did we name that function? Account links. So hop over to your file HTML codes, which is obviously where we write functions to produce HTML codes, and add a little comment that says code for account pages links. Now, the very first thing that we need to do is we need to include the file that calculates all the statistics. So in order to do that, just write include, and of course the function include, you need to write what file do you want to include. Functions, and if you can't remember, we named it fun underscore user stats dot php. Let me make sure I spelled that right. User stats dot php. Good. So basically now everything from this user stats file is now in here. So we can use any of those functions to calculate user statistics. Awesome. So now what we need to do is we actually need to build a function that creates the HTML code for the links on the left hand side. So of course, function, and we named it, what did I name it? I keep forgetting. Account links, and it gets passed in a number. Account links, and we'll call the parameter that gets passed in X. Now you guys will understand why we're passing in that number in a second, but for now, just hold your horses, we'll get to it. So the very first thing that we want to do is, just accidentally hit caps lock on my computer, is we want to store their session ID in a simple variable, because that session variable looks really ugly. Unless you want to type this all the time, $_session user underscore ID. I really don't want to type that every single time I'm working with their session ID, so that's why I changed it to a nice shorter variable, my ID. I'm just going to treat these like these are my links. They belong to me. So anyways, guys, if you heard that, that was my vinyl chair. I swear I didn't just toot right now. So now, check this out. In order to make these functions incredibly easy to work with, let's think about this. Each of these functions calculate an important statistic for the user and returns either a blank or a number in between parentheses. It basically returns a string of how many items it figured out. So instead of calling the function and throwing it in other weird functions, what I decided to do is I want to store each of these strings in a nice, easy to understand variable, such as this. All pending is the number that it returns. It pretty much counts up all of the items that you have pending, and it's going to be stored in this variable. Simple enough. So all pending equals calculate all pending items. So of course this function is going to return a string, and it's going to return it in this variable right here. So of course this is a lot more easy to work with than this, so that is why I'm storing them in variables. Simple enough. Now I guess I might as well take you guys through what all of the functions do right now, so it's really easy to understand. All reported equals calculate all reported items. Now what reported items are is whenever you are browsing the website and you see that someone uploaded pictures of spam, or maybe they say something, maybe they're like posting links to pornography websites in their description, then you can go ahead and report that item. If someone reported your item, then it's gonna go to a certain reported section, so that's what that is. Now The next variable is users active, and of course this is the user's active items. Now, active items are basically whenever you list the item or add an item to the website and it gets approved, which means, okay, you met all the criteria, you didn't have porn images or you didn't have spam, it's good to go. It's going to be active and it's going to be eligible to trade. Now, instead of the user ID, we actually want to throw in my ID, and that's going to calculate all the active items for whatever user is viewing these links. Now, after this is users pending, and I think that this was the function that we made in the last tutorial, if I'm correct. What this does is it calculates all the pending items from the user or for the user, and you guys already know what pending items are. And after this, let's see. Okay, calculate users' offers received. Of course, whenever you add an item to the website, I just want to separate this so they don't get all jumbled together. Let me type this first. Users offers EIVED. There we go. Make sure I spell it right. Okay, whenever you add an item to the website, people can make an offer on your item. For example, if I listed my Xbox games and someone offered me a frog, then that would be one offer that I receive. So then this number would be one. And hopefully someone offers me a frog because I really like frogs. Now, after this is offers made. So I was going to copy that, but I'm not that lazy. Users offers made. And this number is basically whenever you make an offer. For example, if someone had, I don't know, a chupacabra to trade and I wanted to offer them a The New Boston t-shirt, then if I made one offer, then this number would be equal to one. Now, offers made and users completed trades, I think, is next. Users. Now, completed trades, I know this is kind of self-explanatory, but I wanted to talk you guys through this anyways. Completed trades is whenever two people complete a trade, whenever I trade my t-shirt for that chupacabra, and I say, okay, that's a good deal, he says it's a good deal, we shake hands, that's going to go in a new section called completed trades. Both of those items are no longer going to be active or eligible for trading since they were already traded. So then, if you traded one item, this number would of course be equal to one, so on and so forth. Now, the last statistic that I'm going to store in a variable is users unread messages. Now, the reason that I don't want to store the total number of messages and only the unread messages is because we only want to alert the user whenever they have new messages. We don't want to bore them with, they don't care how many messages they got overall. As soon as they log in, they want to say, see, oh, how many new messages do I have? So calculate users unread messages basically calculates how many messages that they have, how many new messages that they have, basically, is what I'm trying to say. So now let me just go ahead and check over this one more time. Pending, reported, active, pending, received, made, completed trades, and unread messages. Okay, so now we have all of these very complicated statistics stored in nice, easy to work with variables. So now what we can do is we can move on to the next tutorial, and in the next lesson, what I'm going to be doing is I'm finally going to be showing you guys why you pass in that number zero for here. And it's actually a really cool feature that I built in, and it's actually really easy to code in your website. So anyways, that's what we're going to be doing in the next tutorial. So yeah, I'll see you then.